So today we have with us three very celebrated and accomplished women entrepreneurs. Let me introduce you to them. Here's Kriti Baveja of momsjoy.com, Shalini Saluja of Indie Cotton Root, and Priya Prakash of Health Set Pro. So as an organization, Knowlarity really promotes entrepreneurship. But what most people don't realize is that entrepreneur as a term is gender neutral. So it's amazing to see this crop of exceptionally talented women entrepreneurs with us who are doing exceptionally well, are very prominent and successful businesses. So Priya, you've categorically gone on record. Shalini and Kriti, you guys read at engineering colleges before you decided to give it up and pursue your own website and label. So we want to know the challenges that you faced when you started out.
What I can tell you is that I think I was discussing with them as well before that initially when you start off as a young woman, so I also looked quite young and I also felt at that time that that would be to my disadvantage, that the kind of industry that I work in, which is a schools industry, where the principals are always 50 plus. You know, and whenever you're meeting somebody who's a principal and she looks down on you as her child, you know, I never wanted to be that person. And secondly, whenever I used to go out and I used to meet a lot of male people in meetings, I always felt like they weren't really comfortable kind of talking to me directly. If I had a male person with me, they would directly look at them and talk to them instead of me. So it's some personal things that I faced initially when I was starting out. But it's been about 3 years since I started out. And I think now the ecosystem is changing. People do expect younger people to come into meetings to meet the CEOs, to meet the heads of departments, to meet the principals. They're not now surprised that why is this young girl walking into a room. They do have faith that whatever I'm talking about has some validation. And so in that way, I think now the ecosystem has become positive for women overall.
Great. Shani, what about you?
See, like you pointed out that I did my electronics engineering. So when I picked up my first job, I used to work in the basement of a company where I used to take care of an assembly line. And at this company, actually, we were making color TVs for Samsung at that time. So I used to enter the factory at 8:30 in the morning and come out at 7 in the evening. And I never could see the light of the day also. So my life, I was making color TVs, but actually my life had become colorless. So that's what I thought, that this is not the kind of life that I actually want to lead, you know. So that was one reason I wanted to be motivated in the morning, when I get up in the morning, and be excited about the work. So that was one thing that I, you know, which made a difference in my life. The other thing what made me take up that as a challenge to do my own work was that I realized that, you know, I was working for a company and I was, supposing I have a fixed life, supposing I have 80 years of life or something. So I was actually selling that part of my life to the company where I was working for a fixed amount of money. And I thought that I have a fixed life, why should I give it to somebody else for a fixed amount of money? I should do what I am excited about, what I am motivated about. So that was a big challenge for me. But actually that I overtook, and you know, I wanted to establish my business and pursue my dream. So that's how it happened.
So I think for me, since a very young age, I've been very creative. And eventually I landed up doing computer science engineering, which I genuinely am really grateful about, because all these things, whatever you learn, whenever you, whether you're doing computer science engineering or electrical engineering, everything, the way you think logically, that all makes sense in the bigger picture when you're running a business. But I worked as an analyst with S&P Capital IQ and also at Accenture. But I was really looking for something where I could provide value to someone else apart from my own self. I was really looking to like find that idea which would really make sense in the bigger picture, like she said, like getting up every day in the morning and feeling motivated about it. That is so important. And when was it exactly that I started momsjoy.com was actually a personal story, that me and my very close friend, we started momsjoy. And both of us had a friend who was expecting, and she was really upset about not finding the right clothes to wear for a party. And you know, that hit us. It hit us that how can we're here because of our mothers, and creating life is like so important and so beautiful, and yet this process is not given importance to. So how does this even make sense? So that really hit us, and we started researching and understanding what are the needs of mothers and why are they not able to find the right sort of clothes. what were the problems that they had. Like, for example, there was a study which was done, which I mentioned to them earlier as well, that, you know, expecting mothers, the two main reasons why they're anxious during pregnancy, one was because of breastfeeding, and two was about the way they looked. You know, that shouldn't be the case again, correct? When you think about it logically, and pregnancy in India is very underrated, but it's changing, right? And we are the people who can actually make this change. And so we decided to use the power of fashion, and we created clothes which were functional and fashionable at the same time and comfortable. So they transition into nursing wear as well, right, as an example of what we're doing. So I think that was a time when I really decided that when it all made sense in the bigger picture that we'll be providing, you know, it's not a fashion brand, but you're actually empowering mothers to make them feel beautiful and confident about themselves, is the time where I personally decided that I wanted to really, really do this. And then I quit my job against my parents' wishes, and well, it's worked out well.
So what is the best piece of advice that you ladies have been given?
What is the best piece of advice?
Yeah. About? That you've ever been given.
I've ever been given?
Yes.
About how to try.
Actually, I answered this. So basically, initially when I started a health business in schools, I thought I need to get these experts on board. We do a lot of health education in schools. I thought I'll have to get an expert on board, some kind of huge doctor to sign off on all of this, because I'm not a doctor. And, you know, I have to get a PhD or a professor to write on all our educational content on health. And I went to one of the most prominent people in the healthcare business today. And I asked him, you know, doctor, this is what I need to do. Who do you recommend? Can you suggest a doctor? And this person is like a Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan. I mean, the guy, you know, in healthcare, I just worshipping him. And he said, Priya, if you really want to do something, you don't need anybody else. You have Google.com, you have Wikipedia, go there. All the professors are there online. Don't pay someone a crazy sum of money to build what you know you can build on your own. You can do it, just build it. And with that confidence, I started building a lot of modules for kids, which eventually now are backed by doctors. And it's just amazing, you know, sometimes you feel like it's out of your scope, but a simple advice can just make you go and do it. So I think that was a very good piece of advice that I got.
Any of you would like to?
Yeah, I think there are two things that I want to mention. One is, if you don't ask a question, the answer is always no. So So I mean, if anyone wants to be an entrepreneur, just have to take that first step. Right? And don't be afraid then. Right? Because, you know, there are two ways that it could work. Either you could fail. When you fail, you learn. If you succeed, you fly. So both those things made a lot of sense to me. And another thing that I feel is, things cannot be perfect when you're starting. So don't be too hard on yourself. Because personally, I've seen that change in myself. It was a perfect piece of advice to me that, you know, you can't always make the perfect brand or the perfect product. You have to go out there with what you have. Test, improvise, make the mistakes, understand your customer, and then move on, right? And that's the best way. So that would be like perfect advice, I would say, in business perspective.
See, yeah, actually for me, the advice is actually coming from our clients, you know? So the clients are the ones who tell us, okay, this is what we want. Mm-hmm. This is what, you know, this is our requirement. So yeah, actually you're pivoting with the client. So you understand the pulse of the audience. So it is not just like one advice. There are advices which are coming in every day, and you just have to keep your eyes, ears, your senses open to those and understand from them and then change according. So that's what I would say the advice for me has
worked
always.
So be open to feedback and try this crazy method called asking a question.
Of course, I mean, like raising the hand. Like, so I read somewhere that it was a study by Carnegie Mellon which said that out of the number of 57% of the people who actually negotiate for their salary, only 7% were women. Okay, so raising your hand and actually telling people to raise their hand is so important, especially like in a community of women. So that was something that really hit me, and I literally felt that, you know, so many times there might have been, you don't take the initiative yourself and you don't ask that question. So I think
many times we hold ourselves.
Yeah, exactly. Just because you feel that you might be labeled or judged as being too, maybe, I don't know, like assertive women at times are said to be too dominating, right? So there are tons of things going on in our
heads. In fact, on the woman side, a lot of people say, you know, you have to be like a guy when you're running a business. You have to be like a man, be very dominating, assertive. Only then people will listen to you.
Exactly.
That's not my management style. That's not how I manage my people. Like, I mean, I think it's okay to have your own side of, you know, style of management. You don't have to always be aggressive. Women are told to sometimes be aggressive, and only that's the way to succeed. That's the way to get up, you know, in the business world. I don't believe that to be true.